Today, in this video, I want to solve two problems. When we want to send emails from our website, or maybe cold emails, we want to look professional and we want to reach the inbox. And this is exactly what I will do today. How? Simply by creating a professional business email address. And what's nice, it's 100% free. Keep watching. Let's start and see the importance of business email address in just 30 seconds. Let's see an example. This is my inbox. If you go and open this email here, you will see it's an email from @gmail.com. Let's go back to my inbox and open this email and see it is from a domain name @studypool.com. So it's a company email address. Just small question. Which one do you believe it's more professional and I can trust more? I will give you 1 second to think. Obviously the one with a domain name. And the second important thing is that with a business email, we are using trusted companies, verified companies like Google, like Microsoft, like other companies. And this will help us a lot to reach the inbox directly. Now let's see how you can create a business email. What are the available methods out there to create a business email? Then I will show you how to create one totally for free. So number one is Google Workspace. Maybe you know it as Google G Suite. You can start with $6 per month. By the way, I use Google Workspace. It's an awesome service. The second one from Microsoft, you can start with $5 per month per user. Again, Office 365 also is one of the best services out there to start a business email or get the full business suite from Microsoft. So both methods are paid. We don't want them in this video today. But what's nice, if you are interested to learn how to create a business email with Google G Suite or Workspace or Microsoft Office 365, I have 2 free courses here on my channel. You can check them in the description below. The second method is to get a free email with your hosting plan. As an example, if you are using Hostinger, hosting company, you will see with this plan for $2 per month, you can get 1 email account for free with your plan. And if you go here to email hosting, you can get a business email for $0.99 per month. Again, we don't want this method. We want totally free method. Maybe someone will tell me my hosting plan doesn't have an email account. I want a free business email. So this is why I will show you how to create one for free from scratch. But before, we still have the third method. Did you know that you can create a mail server by yourself in like 30 minutes and you can have unlimited business emails? Even you can sell these business emails. I explained this in one of my courses on my academy, but what's nice, soon, next month, I will create a free course here on my channel showing you how to build a mail server and have unlimited emails. So don't forget to like the video and turn on notifications to get every new update. So without wasting more time, I think this is enough for now. Let's see how we can create a free business email. Open your browser and go to zoho.com/mail. What is Zoho? It's simply a service that allows you to create a free business email. You can see here I logged in with my Gmail account. Just sign up, it's free. And you can see here, get started with add free email. Business email or personal email, I will select business email, sign up for free. You can see here it says $1, $4, $3. But just scroll down and you will see forever free plan, 5 GB per user. Awesome. Click sign up here and let's start creating our free business email. Before I recorded this video, I did a lot of research about creating free business emails. I tested more than 5 to 6 methods. I believe this is the easiest way you will ever see. There are some more complicated methods like email forwarding with a Gmail account and so on. I believe this is the easiest and the best in terms of creating a business email. Hasan, my Gmail account. I will add a password. I agree. Sign up. Now you can see it says this account already exists because I already signed up before to test it. So anyway, just sign up with your email account. I will sign in now to my account so we can follow up together. And here we are. When you log in, you will see this screen in the dashboard. It will ask you to add an existing domain or buy a new domain. Now, since this video is part 11 in our online business series, if you are following me, we got a domain in part 1 or 2. If you don't have a domain, you must get your domain name. Anyway, I will add an existing domain because I have one. And what is my domain? embounce.com. You know, we are building a website here in this online business series. Just in 2 seconds for new people here, we are building a full business to reach $2,000 per month working online from home. And this is the website I am building from scratch with you in this series. So this is my domain name. I will put it here. I will add embounce, anything, industry type. I will say education, anything. Choose your industry type, add. Now we need to verify this domain. Click on proceed. And we'll show you we have two options. You can log in to your domain provider, in my case GoDaddy, and it will automatically authenticate, or you can verify manually. I will select this method because this method will work with anyone. I will go and open GoDaddy domains, and this is my domain name. I will click on DNS to manage my DNS records. Okay, so going back to Zoho here, just copy this value here, go back to GoDaddy, add, select text record. And by the way, it's the same if you are using Namecheap or Enum or whatever company. Just add a DNS record. The type is text, the value is add, which means the same domain, and the value here, add record, and that's it. Success. Let's go back here, verify text record. We verify the ownership. Now let's enter a username at embounce.com. I will say admin, for example. You can use whatever you want. Support, admin, your name. I will say now admin at embounce.com. Create, setting up the users. You can see it's a simple wizard. This is why I told you it's the easiest method to create a business email. This is the users. Proceed, set up groups. We don't have anything here. Proceed to DNS mapping. Now you need to set the mail exchange. Change records. What is the MX records? They are simple records in DNS that tells everyone on the internet, hey, when you send an email to embounce.com, redirect them to this mail server. Is the mail exchange record. Anyway, just follow up with me now. Copy this address, go back to your DNS, add MX record, say add, the priority is 10, the value add record. Again, let's copy the second one, MX2 is 20, then add MX20, paste, add record, simple, huh? Copy the third one, again, add MX at this is 50, and then paste this one, add. And now you can see we have 3 MX records. This one, priority 10, priority 20, and this one, priority 50. By the way, I always say this. If you have questions, if you want maybe some more clarifications, if you love technical stuff and you want to learn more about MX records, I will be available almost every day on my Telegram group. And on the forum, you can ask whatever you want. We can chat together and help each other. You'll find the links in the description below. Okay, so now let's verify. Proceed to SPF configuration. What is SPF? If you are following my email marketing videos and courses, I explained SPF, DKIM, DMARC, and I talked in detail about it. SPF is simply a record to secure your email and your domain. So only you can use your domain to send emails. It prevents spammers and scammers to use your name and your domain to send emails. Anyway, again, just copy this record and go back to GoDaddy, add text record, paste this. You can see SPF, the value, it includes only Zoho. So only Zoho can be used to send using your domain. And this all means that everyone else can do this. So add a record. Let's wait a little bit. Now let's go back. Click on verify. It may take now some time to verify. Just wait a little bit, maybe 30 minutes. Sometimes it takes 1 day depending on your domain provider. Verify. We don't need to wait. Let's continue. Understood. Now the last record is the DKIM record. Again, DKIM is another security record that protects your email. And by the way, setting up SPF and DKIM is very important and helps you in reaching the inbox when you send a campaign. If you want to know more about DKIM, SPF, DMARC, and email security, you can check my email marketing videos in the description below. So I will copy this record, go back to GoDaddy, add text, paste the value here, this key, text name, this is the host or the name, and add record. That's it. Again, it may take some time, you see, between 30 minutes and 1 day depending. Skip to email migration. Understood. We are almost done. We don't need to do anything here. Just skip. You can connect your mobile phone phone with your email so you can check your business email from your phone if you want. I will skip this for now. It's not important for us. Go to admin console or check out your inbox. You can go log into your inbox here if you want, or go to the admin. Anyway, I'm logging in to my inbox now. Let's wait a little bit. And you can see this is our mailbox, our inbox. Let's test this. I will go to my Gmail account, compose. I will send to admin@embounds.com. Hi admin, this is a test email to Zoho. Send. Let's go back here to the inbox. And awesome, you can see a new email from my Gmail account. You can read it here and you can reply, you do whatever you want. You have a free business email. We are not finished yet. We still have other problem we want to solve in our main website. If you go here and log in to our WordPress dashboard in our WordPress website, you will see that this error will pop up. SMTP mailer plugin cannot send email until you enter your credentials. I told you before that I'm going to solve this soon in the series, and this is the time to solve this problem. So what I'm going to do here is to go to plugins and go and click on add new, and I will search for WP SMTP plugin. This one here, I will install it. This plugin allows you to use third-party services like SendGrid, like Zoho, like Gmail, any service to send emails from your WordPress. Why do we do this? Simply because if you are using a VPS server or whatever hosting, sometimes the email port will be blocked automatically, or the reputation of your IP will be low, so you will not reach the inbox. So it's very important to use third-party services using this plugin. Activate it. Go back to dashboard. You can see now it shows you that SMTP mailer is activated. Please deactivate it. Okay, go back here to plugins, installed plugins, and we need to deactivate the main SMTP plugin, which we installed before, I think. This one. Deactivate. Very nice. Now refresh. And we need to configure this plugin. How? If you go down here, you will see the from email, from name, and the mailer. In the from email, I will say admin@embounds.com, my business email. From name, I will say embounds. What is a from name? This that will appear here. You can see like this one, Zoho team, is the from name. And this is the from address, you can see. So you are setting these parameters here. Then we need to enter the mailer. And you can notice here we have a lot of services like Google, like Spark Post, one of the best services, by the way, I used it before. Postmark also. Those are the top services, Mailgun. And we have also Zoho Mail. But to use Zoho Mail here, you need to go with a premium activation. But as I mentioned before, we want to keep things free. You can use it if you want, but we want to keep things free. So as an alternative, you can go with SendGrid or Mailgun, or I think also SendinBlue, they have a free plan. Let's go here to SendGrid to show you this. If you go to pricing, you can see this free account, 100 emails per day. I think for a new website, it's more than enough. It's transactional emails only, like you said, passwords and so on. So 100 emails is more than enough for you to start. And if you go here to mailgun.com, you will see they have something better. If you go here to pricing, in this flex method, you can get 5,000 free emails per month for 3 months. Also, you can start with this if you want. Then you pay 0.80 per 1,000 emails. If you go here to SendinBlue, they also provide an SMTP service. Let's see if they have a free tier. For free, you can send up to 300 emails per day, which is also good. Let's see the solutions. They have the API. So it's up to you what you want to select. Now in this video, I will show you how to work with SendGrid as an example. And if you need to implement anything else like Amazon SES, which I explained also in detail in a full free course here on my channel, I'll keep the link in the description also. Whatever you want, I will be with you in the forum in Telegram to help you in any specific configuration you want. But for now, to implement something in this video, I'm going to go with SendGrid. So just click on start for free and sign up. Now in my case, I have already an account, so I will not waste time now signing up. I will click SendGrid. I will log into my account. you can see I'm using SendGrid for multiple websites. So what you have to do is go here to settings, then sender authentication, and then you need to add your domain. Click here on authenticate your domain, then select your host. I will select GoDaddy, then click on next. What's your domain? embounds.com. You can see here embounds.com, say next. Again, we need to add these records in the DNS. Be careful here. If you are using GoDaddy, copy this record, open GoDaddy, add a CNAME record, but please here paste and remove the EM bounds part. Just keep the name like this, get the value, paste here and add record. Simple. Again, copy the second one, add CNAME, paste, remove the EM bounds part, copy the value, save. Again, copy this, add CNAME, paste, copy, paste. I will remove this and add record, and we are done. Go back here to SendGrid, click on I have added records and verify. Again, it will take some time maybe to verify the records. In my case, it worked. We did send the authentication and we verified our domain. You can see. Now go to API keys and click on create API key. I will name it embounds website, create and view, and here is the API, copy it, go here, back to our plugin, select SendGrid, paste the API key and enter your domain embounds.com, save settings, and now let's test this email test. And I will select my Gmail account, send email, let's wait a little bit, and awesome, success. The email was sent successfully, so we configured our website with SendGrid and our mailbox with Zoho. Now, when we send emails from our website, we will look professional and we will reach the inbox. As I told you, this is the first step as a beginner to start for free. Later on, you can migrate to Google Workspace. You can get a premium business email. You can build your own mail server if you want, as I will explain soon in my free course here on my channel. I hope this video was somehow valuable. You got some benefit. If you have any questions, again, don't forget on Telegram, the link in the description below, or on our forum. I will be active almost every single day to answer your questions. See you later.